Welcome to everyone. Government and taxes. In our country, three levels of government. Union government, state government and local government. So this government collecting the taxes from the citizen of India. And taxes. So this tax name comes from taxation, which means estimate. Okay. So this tax name comes from taxation. So the meaning of taxation is estimate. And this root of our Indian tax, the root of our Indian taxes, Manuspriti and Arthashastra. The root of our Indian tax is taken from Manuspriti and Arthashastra. So, there are two types of tax. One is direct tax and one is indirect tax. In our government, they are collecting two types of tax, direct tax and indirect tax. So, citizen of India paid the tax to the government, directly paid the tax to the government is called as direct tax. So, this burden of tax we cannot shift it to other person. Direct tax, that particular person should pay the tax to the government. So, this direct tax, this burden of direct tax we cannot shift it to other person. Next one is indirect tax. So this indirectly paying the tax to the government. So mostly this indirect tax they are collecting from goods and services. This indirect tax you are collecting from goods and services. So this burden of taxes we can shift it to other person. Okay. So this burden of taxes we can shift it to other person. Next one is some example for the direct tax, some types of direct tax. Income tax, corporate tax, wealth tax. Okay, so these are some example for the direct tax. Okay, some types of direct tax. So income tax, individual or any organization directly paid the tax to the government is called as income tax. Okay. So, individual person or any organization, any company paid the tax to the government. Directly paid the tax to the government is called as direct tax. And next one is corporate tax. So, corporate means company. For example, MNC. MNC means multinational company, international company. So, MNC company or our Indian organization, our Indian company paying the tax to the government is called as corporate tax. Okay. So, the corporate means it is company. For example, TCL, Wipro, Dell, Bell. So, these are example for the corporate. Okay. So, this corporate company paying the tax to the government, paying the tax to the government is called as corporate tax. So, it also now the example for the direct tax. Okay. So, this corporate tax collecting the tax from different percentage. For example, income more than 50 crore. More than 50 crore. So, this our Indian company. So, getting more than 50 crore, our Indian company should pay the 25% of the tax. Okay. And this MNC company, foreign company, they should pay the tax 40%. They should pay the tax 40%. And this more than 50 crore. Okay. So this is less than 50 crore and more than 50 crore. Our Indian government, our Indian company should pay the 30% of tax and foreign company same, they should pay the taxes 40%. Okay. So this is less than 50 crore and this is more than 50 crore. More than 50 crore, our Indian company should pay 30% and foreign company they should pay the 40% of tax. Okay. So this is corporate. So corporate means company. Our Indian company and foreign company. Next one is wealth tax. So wealth tax means property. So wealth tax means it is property is called as wealth tax. So people have some property. So every year the estimate of the property they should pay the tax to the government. Okay, so every year the estimate of the property they should pay the tax to the government is called as wealth tax. So wealth tax means property. Property means wealth. So for wealth they should pay the tax is called as wealth tax. Okay. Next one is indirect tax. So this indirect tax, the people collecting, the government collecting indirectly is called as indirect tax. Mostly it is goods and services. For example, also some types of indirect tax are stamp duty, entertainment, excise duty. Okay, stamp, entertainment. Excise duty. So these are examples for the indirect tax. Okay, indirect tax. So for example, stamp duty. So stamp duty means if you want to send the letter, the stamp, okay, stamp card or any registration, during the registration period, we are paying the tax to the government. For example, if you are getting the land, 1 lakh means for registration time, you should pay the extra 20,000 rupees. For approximately, I am telling extra 20,000 rupees. That 20,000 rupees is going to government indirectly. Okay, so because the land cost only 1 lakh, but while registration time, you are paying 1,20,000. So in that 20,000 amount, okay, 20,000 rupees, it is going to government. Indirectly is going to government. That is called as stamp duty. It is called as stamp duty. For example, same, if you want to send the letter, if you want to post the letter, you are getting the stamp from post office or any other shop. So that stamp, we are paying the amount of 5 rupees or 50 rupees. So that also one of the tax indirectly we are paying to the government. Next one is entertainment tax. So entertainment, for example, you are going to movie. Okay, you are going to theater, you are getting the ticket. So in that ticket cost us 100 rupees, means this 100, that 100 rupees, it is included tax. Okay, the same 100 rupees, it is included tax. So it is called as entertainment tax, for entertainment purpose. So movie, watching cricket, or going to any park. Okay, so the entertainment, we are paying the tax is called as indirect tax, because we are getting only the ticket. In that ticket, indirectly government getting the tax. Okay, so entertainment tax. Next one is excise duty. So this excise duty is followed ancient period. Okay, so this is the excise duty followed ancient period. At present also, the manufacturing goods we are paying the tax is called as excise duty. Okay, so while manufacturing time, we are paying the tax. We are paying the tax is called as excise duty. Okay, it's called as excise duty. And this income tax. So this income tax, the first time it is collected 1860. This income tax started to collect 1860. Okay, 1860. So in that period, you know, well, 1857, well, Great Revolt of 1857, one of the mutiny faced our India and British East India Company. So in that time, the British government, they got a very loss. So that increased the financial, they collected the income tax from 1860. It was implemented by Sir James Wilson. This income tax collected from 1860, it was implemented by Sir John Wilson. Okay, so this is implemented by Sir John Wilson from 1860. Okay, sorry, Sir James. So Sir James Wilson collected this income tax, introduced the income tax from 1860, because after that mutiny, 1857 mutiny, the government lost, so that they collected the income tax. Okay. So this excise duty, the manufacturing, while manufacturing time, they are paying the tax is called as excise duty. And next one is goods and service tax. Goods and service tax. short form is called as GST. So this GST, the mean of GST, why they brought to, why introduced our Indian government means one nation, one market, one tax. So this motto of this GST is one nation, which is our nation? India. So one nation, one market, then one tax. So this is the purpose they brought the goods and service tax. So before introduced this GST, our government they collected VAT. So VAT means value added tax. Okay, so the before this introduced of GST, they collected VAT, value added tax. After that, our central government, ruling time, Prime Minister of India, Mr. Narendra Modi, introduced this GST, one nation, one market, one tax. Okay, so this GST passed in parliament, this GST passed in parliament 29 March 2017. Okay, and this GST came into effect 1 July 2017. Okay, so this GST passed in parliament 29 March 2017, and this came into effect 1 July 2017, and this tax, it is collected from three types of government: union government, state government and local government. So three types of government also collecting the tax from the citizen. Okay, so based on the goods and services, they are collecting the tax from the citizen. For example, income tax. Income tax, it is collected by central government. Directly it is collected by central government. And next to this, electricity or lottery. So this all collected by state government. This tax is collected by state government. And sometime both state also joined together, they're collecting the tax, is called as integrated goods and service tax. Okay, it is called as IGST, integrated goods service taxes. Okay, so now we can discuss about goods and service tax. So it is known as SGST, state goods and service taxes, and CGST, central goods service taxes. Okay, and next one is IGST, so integrated goods service taxes. So this state government collecting the tax is called as SGST, and central government collecting the tax is called as CGST, central goods service tax, and both state collecting tax is called as IGST, integrated goods service taxes. Okay, and this state goods service taxes will come under the purchase tax, entertainment tax, luxury tax, lottery tax. So it all come under the SGST and CGST. So central excise duty, service duty, countervailing duty. So this all will come under the CGST. And IGST is mostly four major GST rates are 5%, 12%, 18% and 28%. So mostly this GST starting from 0%. From started the 0%, then 5%, 12%, then 18%, then 28%. So this is collected based on the goods and services, collecting the tax from the people. Okay, 0%, 5%, 12%, 18% and 28%. So this 0% our daily needed, like fruits and vegetables, they are not collecting the taxes. Our daily needed of goods, fruits and vegetables, they are not collecting the taxes. So it is 0%. Okay, it is 0%. And next to this, goods and services, for example, total value of added. So total cost. Okay, so total value of cost. So value of cost is 100 rupees. Okay, so value of cost is 100 rupees. And this 100 rupees ST is collecting 9 rupees. ST is 9% is collecting the taxes and CGST is collecting 9% of the taxes. So total 118. The value of cost is the value of product. Okay, the value of product is 118. So this value of product is 100 rupees. So SGST is collecting 9% and CGST is collecting 9%. So total this value of product is 118. So if you are going to shop, if you are purchasing, in that time you can see this bill. If you see the bill means you can understand SGST and CGST. State goods service taxes, central goods and service taxes. So total 9%, here also 9%. Total the value of product is 118 rupees. Okay, so total rate is 118 rupees. And another one is, so this 9 rupees goes to the state government and remaining this 9 rupees going to the central government. The both are also divided, both 9 rupees and 9 rupees. And next one is IGST. So this integrated value of product is 100 rupees. This integrated goods and service taxes the value of product. Value of product is 100 rupees. Okay. The value of product is 100 rupees and IGST is IGST. So integrated goods service taxes 18%. Okay. So integrated goods and service taxes 18 rupees. So total cost is 118 rupees. Okay. For example, this our Tamil Nadu consumer. Okay, our Tamil Nadu seller selling the product to the Karnataka. Okay. So our Tamil Nadu seller selling the product, selling the goods to the Karnataka. So that Karnataka from that Karnataka they're getting the amount. Okay, they're getting the amount 18 rupees. This 9 rupees goes to 9% goes to the Karnataka government and remaining 9% goes to the central government. Okay, remaining 9% goes to the central government. Okay, so seller in Tamil Nadu. Now, Tamil Nadu seller community to buy around other state because that Karnataka people only buyer only just giving the amount to the Tamil Nadu and purchasing the commodities. So that this collecting IGST, integrated goods and service taxes. This integrated means both state also. Okay. Both state also. So total they collecting 18 rupees. So 9 rupees going to the Karnataka government and remaining 9 rupees going to the central government. Okay. Going to the central government. And next one, this collecting the both state government and central government is petroleum product, alcohol drinker. So this all petroleum product is all is collecting from both central government, the central government and state government. Okay. And alcohol drinker, electricity is all collected by the state government. Okay, collecting the tax by the state government and daily necessity like vegetable, food grains and all, they don't want to pay the tax. Okay. And this GST they implemented the first country as France in 1954. GST is implemented in the first country is France. Okay. So this taxes divided into two types. One is direct taxes, another one is indirect taxes. Okay. So this direct taxes, some types are income tax, wealth tax, corporate tax. And indirect tax, some types are stamp. Okay, stamp duty, entertainment. So these are all types of indirect tax. To develop the financial status, they are collecting the tax from the citizen of India. So it is compulsory. So paying the tax to the government, it is compulsory, it is mandatory. They should pay the tax. Okay. We should not say we can't pay the tax to the government because it is compulsory. We are citizen of India. This is our fundamental duties. This is fundamental duties. We should pay the tax compulsory. Okay. Next, learn the following. The question is, Write the structure of GST, goods and service tax. Next one, explain some direct and indirect taxes. Next one, write short note on goods and service taxes. So read well. Thank you. Have a nice day.